Have you ever wondered what it's like to attend an American wedding? Is it prim and proper with everyone dressed up in formal attire? Do people eat steak and drink wine while discussing the fine things in life? Or are things a bit wilder than on the silver screen? Stay tuned and... Don't believe me, just watch! Hi everyone, it's Carrie, and this week I was invited to my cousin's wedding, so my family and I flew to Indianapolis for the weekend. The rehearsal is always the day before the wedding.
Getting ready for the rehearsal dinner right now. So this is what I'm wearing to the rehearsal. I'm wearing heels too. I have a huge sock line on my feet. Rehearsals aren't normally like dressy, so this is just kind of like a little, oh, I'm going out to dinner kind of look.
Normally, only close family goes to the rehearsal, but because we came in from out of town, we were invited. The rehearsal went fairly fast, and it was mainly about placement and timing for those who are participating in the wedding. In this wedding, there are no bridesmaids or grooms, so it was just close family who walked down the aisle, like parents, grandparents, and siblings. Then, it was time for the rehearsal dinner. The rehearsal dinner is another tradition, and is traditionally paid for by the groom's family, while the wedding is paid for by the bride's family. The groom's family booked out a room in a restaurant. Everything except the drinks were paid for by them. So let's talk gifts. Typically, around a month before the wedding, there will be a bridal shower, where guests will give the bride gifts to help contribute to her home, such as a gift card to a home store or something else. So what do guests give to the newlyweds on the day of? Usually money, enough to cover the cost of you attending the wedding and more, and it also depends on the closeness to the relative. The meal was a pre-planned 5-course, with 2 choices for an entree. A lot of mingling went on, as well as a speech from the groom's family, paired with a toast, of course. The appetizer was salad and bread. The entree was served family style, with the option of steak or salmon. The sides were salad, mashed potatoes, and mac and cheese. A dessert of bread pudding was served to complete the 5-course meal. Afterwards, everyone went to a bar next door to continue the good times. The next day was the day. Bear with me because I have a lot to explain. In America, dowries are not a thing. If a couple loves one another, they will get engaged, traditionally with the permission of the bride's father. In this case, the couple paid for the majority of the wedding themselves. This is a deviation from the norm, but traditional weddings aren't as common anymore. This is the flower girl, my little cousin.
I've never heard how to say hi, my name is Vivian in Chinese.
So then say it.
Ni hao, what's all, Vivian?
Yeah, very good.
Another deviation in this wedding was the bride and groom seeing each other before the marriage. Usually, the couple should not see each other the day of until the bride walks up the aisle, which is why veils were popularized as well. Everyone took pictures while we were all dressed up. Another quick tradition is something old, new, borrowed, and blue. The bride must have all of these present on her special day. It doesn't matter how it appears in the wedding, it could even be a blue manicure. And obviously, I took some pictures while I was dressed up as well, but not without my aunt making fun of me first. Then, it was time for the wedding. They gave out bubbles to blow instead of throwing rice. Throwing rice at the end of the wedding is also another tradition. It's kind of like confetti. The flower girl proceeded at record-breaking speed. The bride and her father walked down the aisle and he gave her away to the groom. A friend of the couple was the officiant. They said their vows, put rings on one another, and said I do. Then it was time for the kiss. Then everyone moved into where the reception was being held. This was the guest book. We took a Polaroid and wrote a message. The celebration of the newlyweds began. The first stop for everyone was the bar, apparently, because it was an open bar. Hors d'oeuvres were served as everyone took their assigned seats. The first course was a salad and bread. Back in the day, it was uncommon for couples to be affectionate before marriage, so to help ease the tension, the newlyweds were made to kiss whenever the guests clinked their glasses. The cake was brought out and both wine and champagne were served, but the champagne is reserved for the toast. The main course was served. I chose steak. After the entree, the cake was cut. The couple feed one another with their hands and drink champagne. The top tier of the cake is reserved to eat for the first anniversary. Afterwards, the best man and maid of honor gave their speeches. They were both siblings of the newlyweds, so the stories were personal and well told. The wedding was also chosen to be smaller, so it was more personal. Next came the first dance. Followed by the last dance with the bride and her father. It's usually emotional. And then came the dance between the groom and his mother. This one was more upbeat. Cake was served, then the dance floor was opened. Young or old, everybody got out there. White people love doing group dances. This one is called the Cha-Cha Slide. Most weddings also have photo booths. This time, my family imitated a pose I used to always do. This one was digital, but at the last wedding I went to, it had a photo booth. Needless to say, that provided a lot of entertainment, especially for those who drank a bit more than the rest. Later on, more food was provided, as it was nearing 8 p.m. It was mini burgers and fries. These fries and this song got me a bit carried away. Dance floors are at every American wedding. I've never been to one without it. It's honestly my favorite part. I love watching my family get loose, have fun, and celebrate. I danced with my younger cousin and sung my heart out with my older cousin.
You wanna dance?
As the night neared its end, we all took a final picture. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!